You're in the rant hole where I rant about whatever my $15 a month plus patrons want me to rant about. You can get a rant by becoming one of those people. Today's comes from Alex the Pyro, who wants me to rant about copycat YouTubers, musicians, etc. And either people who are just copying someone else wholesale or doing it as a way to start out as a new creator. And I would say that copying other people is a great way to start. There are some people who will tell you not to. I don't know why. Everybody has their own logic about what they think you're supposed to do as a creator or whatever, but, like, if you want to do something that is similar to someone else, the best way to figure out how to do it is to copy what they do and try to see if you can do it. Because in the process, you'll come to realize, like, in order for you to effectively copy someone else, you have to be able to understand what they did. And so if you try to copy somebody and then you realize that your product has come up short, then you have to kind of look at it and go like, okay, well, what did I do wrong? How come mine is not coming out at the same level as theirs or isn't achieving the same level of success as theirs did? And, you know, ask yourself how you can make it better. And personally, I am somewhat of a style assimilator. When I, like, witness something that I really like and that I feel like it resonates with me and it comes from a similar place as me, a similar kind of voice, but they're doing things in a different way that I admire, I try to figure out how can I incorporate that into my work. And you can find tons of my videos that are directly in reference to other people's shit. I mean, even right now, I'm doing a Let's Argue series. Literally didn't even change the name from what the Needle Drop does on his Let's Argue series. And it's because I saw that and I went, okay, I like this format. It seems like something that would work well for me. Like, I can talk in a similar fashion to him, but I can talk about anime, whereas he talks about music. So there will be enough difference that, you know, we can both be doing this, and there will be a reason to consume both. And even though I found out later that the anime man was already doing a series like that, but his style of humor and his editing technique and everything is very different from the way that I would do it or that DeVu, who's been editing them now for me, would handle the editing. So when you get mine, you can see the differences in how, like, I tend to ramble a lot longer than, like, the Needle Drop would usually about a particular topic. You know, I give a more in-depth breakdown of a response. You know, DeVu tends towards more, like, wacky editing, like, more visual gags. Fantano's and Anime Man are both more, like, zoom in on the face, quick, snappy gags, whereas me and DeVu are more, like, weird, absurdist humor that gets thrown in there. But, you know, essentially it's the same kind of thing, but the more I do it, the more I can learn from it, and then eventually incorporate those styles into something I do going forward, you know? And, like, I've taken a lot of influence from the meme review in the way that I was editing my my videos, like, early 2018, from Fantano as well. Obviously, Your Movie Sucks was an influence when I did my Your Anime Sucks videos, where I tried to copy his style, but then to, you know, again, just add little changes and, like, what would I do? How would I interpret this style? What do I not like about his style that I would want to change to evolve it into mine? And then once I've done that, then going forward, you know, I find a way to remix that with all the other things I like and try to create a sort of amalgam of all the different influences I have that I've tried to, you know, copy and understand and then, you know, add all of that to my palette, so to speak. So it's like, you know, as a musician, there are a lot of musicians who just basically try to sound like their favorite band, and that's all they do. And if you're just doing that, then it kind of is like, is there really a need for you to exist? And I'm sure that there are some audience members who will appreciate the fact that, like, inherently you're going to sound somewhat different. Like, unless you are literally just playing the same songs, if you're writing something that's very similar, you know, you are not that person who you look up to. And it's possible that, even unintentionally, you will morph it in such a way that it speaks to a different audience, you know? It might be that whatever experiences you have that you draw from in your creation of that music, you know, you're not necessarily creating, even if you're copying that person deliberately, you can't create the same thing because only that person can create that thing. What you're creating is something based on your interpretation of their thing. So it might be that your interpretation warps the original just enough that it comes out differently and a different type of person is interested in it. But I think that most of my favorite artists, at least, are people who, you know, are clearly taking from a whole lot of different people who have experimented with trying all these different sounds and then come up with something on the basis of that. And there's a lot you can learn, you know. For instance, me doing these simple vlogs came as a result of copying Max Landis, a screenwriter who would just throw on his camera and rant about things in a high-energy kind of way, just whatever happened to be on his mind. And the way he did that made me think, oh, I could do that too, but, like, the kinds of things I rant about are completely different from the kind of things he rants about. And, like, if you watched his vlogs and mine, you wouldn't necessarily think, oh, Digi's copying this guy, you know, because it's just, there's not that much content similarity. We have very different personalities. However, just the general approach of, I'm gonna just flip on a camera as soon as I have an idea and just, like, bam, get it out there with tons of energy, like, that is a copycat idea, you know? It just naturally gets changed by me doing it. So, you know, if you find yourself dwelling too much on, like, copying one creator and just trying to be them, I think that, you know, and that's just gonna not be that interesting to most people. But I don't think there's anything inherently wrong with it, because, again, you can't just create the same product. It's not going to come out the same because you aren't them. And people will be able to tell. Like, nobody's going to... If you rip off somebody completely and yours is just as good as theirs, it just means that their product was already pretty generic, that it's something that anybody could have done. They were just the first to do it. But, like, I've seen on YouTube especially tons of times where somebody created a style and then somebody else did it better. They just took that ball and ran with it and made a better version of the same. And it makes the original seem, you know, quaint and irrelevant afterwards. It's just because those are people who identified what was going on. And instead of saying, ooh, how can I incorporate that into my style? They looked at it and go, ooh, that's a good idea, but you didn't execute it very well. And I know how, you know. So, yeah, you know, imitation is the most sincerest form of flattery.